discovery, of excitement, of appreciation, and most importantly, of thanksgiving. It's a day of self-revelation that 6 years ago, MK, Ahmed, Nakamobi Arara, Lungine, and I walked into WTU to start a journey we would never begin and see a different side, a more passionate side of a woman I love and I am thankful for. I'd like to thank those that stood by me in times of struggle and self-discovery. Most importantly, I'd like to thank two close friends of mine, our head boy and my friend for 8 years, Kokeli Nkomo, for believing in my capacity to not only debate, but lead. I recall when we were Form 3 and 4, MK used to stand up and advocate for me to speak in W2, and even going to the extent of boycotting the competition so that I could speak. We have had our differences over time, but great minds are never meant to live together in union, but always to sharpen each other. To you, I thank you. To Alvin, I have nothing but respect for the person you have become. You have taught me how to build myself and how to build those around me. And you have shown me the different sides of people and helping debate and young leaders to coexist in CBC and raise good men of value. I will never forget those days in Ecos where you used to teach me Portuguese, to which I'm about to speak right now. So to you two guys, I would like to say obrigado, mes, imaras, mina, familia. Thank you, my brothers, my family. I also would like to thank all the different schools that are present here today for walking well with us and acknowledging our invitation today. It is also important that I thank you for giving us stern opposition throughout the whole year and your support and the support you gave us when we faced opposition. So to Sylvester, Aisha, Samantha, Bethany, Ayanda, and Charmaine, I say thank you. Merci beaucoup. Now to my two families, my debate family. Firstly, I'd like to thank you for your continued support and your belief in my capabilities as a leader. Firstly, I'd like to say goodbye and thank you to Muzi, who throughout the years has become like a brother to me and a great friend. To Muno and Ebenezer, we have journeyed this road together. You have shared in my failures and in my successes. You have helped me to become the person I am today. The humor, but always relaxed and in control style, Ebenezer, I will never forget. I also thank you for everything that you have done and the ability to debate that you have. Tachichi, I thank you. And I love this. To Mr. Mnotinaise Matayo, your hard work and determination is unparalleled, and your commitment to the team is unequivocal. You have become a close friend whose advice I'm always willing to take. Poison, thank you for each and everything that you have done for me. I also would like, at this point in time, to thank Andrew, who has become a rock and a foundation for me. Andrew has always been there in terms of when we needed him. I remember when we had to go to South Africa and we did not have a speaker, and Andrew pitched up at the last minute, and gratefully, I don't know whether it's because of me or because of the team, but we won the competition. I am thankful for you, Andrew, for your leadership skills, for your support, and for your friendship. I will never forget our frivolous conversations about the dance, girls, and Victoria Falls, and to more serious issues like Donald Trump and what these elections mean for the rest of the world. I will never forget our discussions about the Black Lives Matter issue and how you have stirred All Lives Matter, and I always tell you, it's a prejudice that is within you. Our relationship has stretched beyond our desks in economics, in history, and in literature. And I thank you for everything that you have done and for helping me in my canvas of life. There's however been one member of our CBC debate community who has extended the club family and my own family. Mrs. Mashaji is not just biologically my aunt or my debate patron, but she is in every right my mother. She has catered for me ever since I could ever remember. I remember when I was a young kid, when I was around 4 years old, when my mother passed away, and I came to live with her. The care that she showed me throughout my life and support, I will never forget. I am eternally grateful for all you have sacrificed for me. Your passion for debate is unrivaled, and that desire to see everyone who who enters into WTO to succeed and become the person they are destined to be is unrivaled by anyone I have ever met. Proverbs 6, verse 20 to 21 says, "My son, keep your father's command and do not forsake your mother's teaching. Bind them always on your heart, fasten them around your neck. And the teachings that she has given me, not only religion-wise, but life-wise, I will never forget, and I will always love her for the person that she is. And I thank her for her gratitude. And even though I have failed in all my things, she has always been there, and she's always supported me. And I would like you to appreciate the token of appreciation that we have done for her today." She recently completed a master's in curriculum studies. We are taking a picture of her and we are about to do a portrait. However, the portrait has been delayed. This arrived from Victoria Falls in the evening, so we could not present it today. Sorry. Lastly, I would like to thank my father and my sister. My father for always believing in my dreams and for providing for me. If it wasn't for you, Dad, I would not be here. I thank you for sacrificing all that you have for my well-being. And for that, I will never stop trying to make your life the greatest it can ever be, and making you proud of the person I am today. Gracias, Patata. To my sister, my rock, thank you so much, Tapio, for your love and support. You are great, and you are an amazing woman of God. You are destined for greater things to come, and I thank God for the person you are to me. In ending to the incoming board of 2017, take every stride as it comes to you, and don't be afraid of any challenges that may be thrown in your path. Always believe in yourself and be assured that the fact that I have put you in this board and the fact that you are going to stand here, you are destined for greatness. In fact, you are greatness itself. And I thank you for each and everything that you have done for. And I thank you because the manner of men that you are is the greatest. And I encourage you all to work together and always keep up your faith. And especially keep your faith in each other. Because as I have realized, having a brother is the best thing that you can ever have. Because a brother can always help you in times of need. A brother can always help you when you are sad. And to that is all you can ever be. So, without bragging, I'd like to say thank you, God, for winning the Inter-CBC Championship, for winning the NASTWEF Championship, for winning the Provincial Championship. Not only that, for winning the ZIT of Climate Championship, and for winning... But thank you, Lord, for each and everything that you have done for this great child. And CBC is something that is a religion. It is something that has the basis of God at its heart. And I thank God for each and everything that he has done for us. Thank you.